Hello students, welcome again our in this video lesson. In the last video lesson we are discussing about the air pollution and effects of air pollution. So while continuing this once again I want to discuss with you about global warming. It's a very important problem nowadays. Before discussing about the global warming, we must know about the greenhouse gases. What are greenhouse gases? Greenhouse gases are basically carbon dioxide, methane, water vapor. These are greenhouse gases. How these gases comes to the atmosphere? Obviously, burning of fossil fuels, then forest fire, and some other natural calamities like volcanic eruptions. Okay. So when this percentage of greenhouse gases increases in the atmosphere, it will make the earth atmosphere warmer. Why? Because you know, carbon dioxide atmosphere does not allow heat of the earth to escape, earth surface to escape. Okay, because we are not getting heat of the sun directly. It first hits the earth surface, and after the reflection of heat, we are getting that heat. And atmosphere does not allow heat of the sun to escape from this earth surface. But if you increase the percentage of these greenhouse gases, lots of heat getting stagnant in this, mainly called troposphere. Okay. So it will definitely increase the earth's temperature. And this random increase in the earth surface temperature leads to the global warming. So this increase in the temperature of the earth surface due to the increase in the concentration of greenhouse gases is called global warming. Global warming are again very harmful to us. They are causing so many effects on it. Suppose first one is the melting of polar ice caps, which leads to the increase in water level in the seas and oceans. And once it get increased water level in the seas, definitely they will come to the coastal areas. So cities around or villages beside the coastal areas will get flooded. Okay, so it is a very big problem and it's a very big threat to the mankind on this earth. Okay, but so it is very important for us to control this air pollution. So how, what can we do? What can an individual can do to reduce this air pollution? So air pollution can be controlled by growing more trees, setting up of factories in non-residential areas. So we can set up factories in quite away from the cities. We can use eco-friendly and non-polluting products. Suppose we can use lots of solar energy instead of burning fossil fuels. Say no to open defecation. This is a very big problem in mostly in villages. Minimize the wastage. So if you follow the 3 R's, that is reduce, recycle and reuse, we can minimize the wastage. We have to control deforestation and promote afforestation, means planting more and more trees and cutting less number of trees will also help us to control air pollution. Besides this, it is another important thing that we have to make people aware about this pollution and make them educate how to reduce garbages, then how to conserve electricity, how to not to go for outside for or open areas for defecations. So in we can educate these peoples about these things, and we have to follow the strictly the guidelines which has given by our government. The government the board is a government sector that has made these rules and regulations to control air pollution is Central Pollution Control Board and Ministry of Environment, Forest, Climatic Change. So if we follow the guideline given by them strictly, we can also reduce this air pollution. Okay, so it is a duty of each and every citizen of a country or all people of this world to do their best to control or check this air pollution. Otherwise, in future, due to the global warming, lots of problems we have to face. And our next generation and even we also are suffering from so many airborne diseases. Then this extreme hotness, we are having some skin problems also. If ozone layer depletion is happening, due to which if harmful rays of the earth sun comes to that surface, it may cause to the skin cancer like problems. So we have to do lots of things to control this air pollution. Otherwise, it is going to be a very big hazard for us. Still it is going on, but in future it will become very big hazard for us. Okay, so this is about the whole chapter. Now we have completed our chapter for final term also. The next video lesson I will discuss few question and answers and online class also. After that your whole syllabus will get over. So after your unit test 4, we will do the revision for your final term. Okay students, so if you get any doubt, you can ask me in your next online class. Thank you very much. See you again.